Well, welcome to Old Classic Car. This morning we find ourselves in deepest, darkest Shropshire, Loton Park hill climb meeting.
Contact.
There are always lots of interesting cars dotted around in the parking, the paddock area, including this lovely little Sunbeam Talbot. The vintage cars, wherever you look, this is a Napier. There's a lovely Ansaldo. There's a Lee Francis. One of many Riley specials. And another one. There's another glorious vintage racer, the Picard Pitet. Here we've got a Hudson-based car.
Okay.
Here we have Spider, a very famous vintage hill climb car. This has been racing for decades, this particular car. You can see the chain drive in there. We've got a vintage Alvis here observing proceedings. Lots of Castrol R smells as we walk around the paddock area. This morning it's practice and timed proper runs in the afternoon. Got a Vauxhall there, YD5735, a couple of Austin 7s. There we have a Talbot.
Attention paddock, the car that's just left the start line will be the last car in this batch. As soon as it successfully passes the finish line, the cars at the top of the hill will be coming back down. Do be aware of them moving around the paddock. Next batch will be classes 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Just a reminder, please don't leave your paddock space until you're asked to do so by one of the paddock marshals, just to prevent any of the access roads being unnecessarily blocked. So classes 4, 5, 6,
ERA. Next to this glorious ERA, we have a wonderful Fraser Nash. Couple of Fraser Nash BMWs, I think. Here we've got a lovely old Alvis with its supercharger out the front. The Alvis Silver Eagle. Another Alvis behind. So let's see what we've got parked up along here. We've got a Wolseley Hornet Special. Try not to get run over. Very nice Lagonda. I think this is a Rapier. Supercharged. My mighty Talbot. Over here, a wonderful Lagonda. Another Talbo. There's usually no shortage of Fraser Nashes at vintage events like this, and here's a wonderful example. And here, an Elvis. There are always plenty of Austin 7 base specials here. And the Bantam. Here we've got the Bantam. This is based on a single Le Mans. Very nice little car indeed. Let's have a quick look inside. Got the offset steering wheel for getting in and out, and let's have a quick look underneath. Another very modified Austin 7. And another one here. Another special here. Is this the one that's called the Wasp, Fraser Nash? Got a Hudson. Heading back down to the paddock now. flag. Ace cameraman at work there. The scent of castor oil hangs heavy in the air. Someone needs to tidy up a bit. Not sure if we saw this one before, but here's a glorious Bentley 3 litre. tucked away in one of the further corners of the public car park is this glorious AC Aceca. This was basically the fixed head version of the AC Ace, 1950s sports car, beautiful example in dark blue. It's interesting how the number plate is hidden behind the Perspex cover. It's such a stylish car. Also in the public car park we've got this XJ4.2C, the coupe version of the Series 2 XJ. These are available with the 5.3 V12 or the 4.2 straight 6. They never did a 3.4 as far as I know. But these two-door coupe versions of the XJ are getting hard to find in good condition. This one's in great order. Here's a rarity, this is a Triumph 2.5 PI Saloon. Most of the ones of these that you see nowadays are the 2000s or occasionally the 2500 or the S. But you don't see many of the PI with the Lucas fuel injection. And one of the few British saloons that looks good on mini light reps as well. In my opinion, of course, but... that's a very rare car. They also did the estate version of that, which is even rarer. Intriguingly, it's got a 2000 on the bumper, overdrive on the rear badge, and PI on the rear quarters. Looks like it does a little bit of road rallying, judging by all those extra gauges and switches in there. Yeah, I like that a lot. Someone stripped down their car for competition. All this will get bolted back on later. Nice petrol can. And parked next to a decidedly unvintage caravan is this glorious Rolls-Royce, sometime from the 1920s. I'll look at the registration. What a fantastic car that is. Many, many fuel tins on the running board. Perfect for a continental touring. Is this the only Porsche 968 that's set up for towing? Lurking over here, we've got an interesting pair of British classics. We've got a 3-litre, I think, Bentley here. Alongside that, possibly even rarer, is a Wolseley Hornet Saloon. We saw a Wolseley Hornet Special earlier on, but this is the saloon version. A little lost in seven, is this a Nippy? Lost in seven corner. We've got an Ulster, probably an Ulster replica. Very popular in these vintage events now. And another one. Bit of spannering going on over here. The Riley Special. Here we've got a very nice vintage Austin 7 Chummy. Here. Guards in there to protect the driver from all the chains whirring around beneath his legs.
This is their first vintage car event.
Oh, good. Are you enjoying
them? Yeah, it's awesome.
Just said this is the coolest contraption on this road because there's just umpteen places you can lose a finger.
There's umpteen places you can do all kinds of nasty things, aren't there?
Yeah. How's it running now?
Well, so.
Give us the job.
That's your best plan, isn't it?
I'm never organised enough, so I usually lot the week before and everything's like 200 quid.
A wonderful Lagonda hiding away here. The beauty of events like this is you can just have a mooch around the paddock, nowhere's fenced off, and just go where you want, keep your eyes open. You can really get a feel for what goes on behind the scenes, not just out on the course. And this is glorious, this Fraser Nash BMW. That is a beautiful car.
Apparently this is a boat. Well, does it belong to somebody?
A vintage Delage here. I've never seen headlamps like that before. This has got to be one of my favourites of the entire event. This Riley is just beautifully turned out.
Thank you.
Just vintage cars.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, 150.
7.5 coming up because there's a friggin' memory on fire.
Oh, I've got 150.
Yeah. I think it was 195 one way, 203 the other.
See you there.
Do it.
Well, if you've made it this far, thanks very much for watching. Please check out some of the other videos on the channel. More videos like this coming along very soon. Bye for now.